Okay, somebody else is asking, Pastor Doug, when does the 7 years of tribulation begin?
After the close of probation, when everybody's being shaken into either receiving the seal of God or the mark of the beast. Something's happening in the world. It's happening now. I think you know from reading prophecy that there's going to be a shaking where everyone is going to polarize. And we see it in our country. Look how polarized the country is on two extremes right now. Mm-hmm. And it's not only in our country. You see it in the nations around the world. Things are getting polarized politically, and they're soon going to be polarized religiously. And it'll eventually transition into the point where everybody either is going to be receiving God's seal and worshiping the true God. The power of God and the truth of God is going to go with a great voice, or they're going to worship the beast in his image. There'll be time of persecution. Some won't be able to buy or sell. During that time, the message is going to go loud and clear. There'll be miracles, signs, and wonders by the beast and by God's people. So we're going to have to know. Remember, Moses, he did a miracle. The Pharaoh's magicians, they did miracles too. Mm-hmm. So during the time before the plagues fell, there was a battle of miracles that were taking place. But then finally, everyone will make their decision. Probation will close. The great time of trouble, the seven plagues, will happen then.
Okay. This person is asking also, I just don't want to leave them wondering. They mentioned 7 years of tribulation. Does the Bible say anywhere that there's the tribulation
yeah,
of 7 years?
No, the great, there'll be a small time of trouble, and no one's sure exactly how long that will be. We're fairly certain the seven last plagues are not 7 years, because it says all of her plagues will come in a day. And that means within a day, within a year. A day in prophecy is a year. So, and you think about it, the severity of those plagues, oceans, blood, fresh water supplies, blood, men scorched with great heat, people being plagued with a noisome sore, darkness on the seat of the beast. You look at those plagues and, you know, life, that's why Jesus said, unless those days would be shortened, no flesh would survive. So the plagues that fell on ancient Egypt happened in a matter of a couple of months. The plagues that Job went through happened in quick succession. It was a matter of a few weeks. Seven last plagues will be very intense, but it's going to be less than a year. Nowhere in the Bible does it say 7 years of tribulation. That's something that is presumed.
Mm-hmm. All right, another question. It says, Pastor Doug, can you say something about the 144,000?
Yes, you want to be part of that number when the saints come marching in.
Right.
the 144,000 are basically your last day apostles. They are not the only ones saved. You look at the descriptions that's given of the 144,000. It says that they follow the Lamb wherever he goes, like the apostles did. The number is 12 times 12,000. You know, something interesting happened in Acts chapter 1. Just before God pours out the Holy Spirit and the message goes like wildfire at Pentecost, it says Peter stood up and said, you know, we used to have 12 apostles. We're down one. Judas hung himself. We need to replace Judas. They went through a process. They replaced Judas. The next word says, then the Holy Spirit fell. They got that number 12 back through the leadership of the 12 apostles. But they were not the only ones saved and filled with the Spirit. There were 120 in the upper room. But the 144,000 are a special group with a special relationship and a special work in the last days. You know, Jesus said of Nathanael, here is an Israelite in whom there is no guile. It says of the 144,000, there is no guile, that they are honest. They follow the Lamb. It kind of defines them as apostles. But through their preaching, a great multitude is converted, and many are saved. Jesus sent the apostles to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. In the last days, you're going to have 12 times 12,000 before the second coming that go to the whole world. That's what it means. But they're not the only ones that are saved.
And I think we have a lesson that talks more about the 144,000, or at least spiritual
Israel.
Yeah,
we do, yeah.
I think that's coming up, so folks want to stay tuned for that one. Pastor.
Did you know that Noah was present at the birth of Abraham? Okay, maybe he wasn't in the room, but he was alive and probably telling stories about his floating zoo. From the creation of the world to the last day events of Revelation, BibleHistory.com is a free resource where you can explore major Bible events and characters, enhance your knowledge of the Bible, and draw closer to God's Word. Go deeper. Visit BibleHistory.com.
Did you know Amazing Facts has a free Bible school that you can do from the comfort of your own home? It includes 27 study lessons to aid in your study of God's Word. Sign up today by calling 1-844-215-7000. That's 1-844-215-7000.
Have you always wanted to be a Bible expert but never knew where to start? Are you searching for answers that will bring you joy, peace, and fulfillment? Then you'll love the Amazing Facts Storicals of Prophecy Bible Study Experience, now available in 18 languages. Featuring 24 easy-to-read lessons, the Storicals are packed with scripture and step-by-step guidance that will give you absolute confidence about what the Bible actually says about the Second Coming, the Rapture, the Antichrist, and the Mark of the Beast. You'll also get the truth about hell and the afterlife, and practical insight about grace, salvation, and how to truly live like Jesus. Even better, it's absolutely free at storicals.com. So don't miss out. Get started on your Bible study adventure today at storicals.com.